Do you think I need a hair transplant? Do you think I need a transplant or just a treatment?
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a single photo of the front to top part of your head, and you're asking a question, do you think that you're ready for a hair transplant? Well, I'll share with you the approach that we have in our practice when someone like yourself comes to us asking exactly that question. There's a lot of opportunity here for you to learn about hair transplants, hair thinning, and I'll introduce to you something we're doing that is different that helps people with hair thinning. So let's start with what's the first thing we ask when someone comes in for an evaluation. We ask about the onset, the age of onset of when the hair thinning began. And we look at the rate and the progression. When you ask a question like, do you think I need a hair transplant? It implies that a single transplant may solve your problem. But it's very important to understand is that hair continues to thin no matter what kind of surgery you do. Hair transplantation, simply in a most simplified concept, is taking hair from a permanent zone, the zone in the back of the scalp. Imagine the baldest man you've ever seen with that narrow band of hair. That hair is genetically resistant to hair thinning. So that hair, whether it's a strip graft, FUE transplant, robotic, whatever device is involved, it's still moving hair from the permanent zone to the area that needs hair. What's the issue with hair transplant? It doesn't stop the progression of hair loss. It does not prevent further progression. And in addition, it's limited in how much hair can be covered, or should I say, how much scalp can be covered. That means that to achieve a certain level of density, it is often necessary to have more than one transplant. So when someone like yourself comes to us, we then look into what are the ways to at least stabilize progression of the hair loss before pursuing or considering a hair transplant. The medical therapies that are currently approved in the United States are finasteride, or brand name Propecia, which is a pill that is taken to reduce a substance called DHT, or dihydrotestosterone, and it's an inhibitor of an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. Now, this will reduce the amount of DHT, which will thereby reduce the susceptibility of certain hairs vulnerable to hair thinning as a response to DHT. Now, not everybody responds to this type of treatment, but in the current time, a lot of men, it's only limited to men, are not taking finasteride because of reports in medical literature about long-term sexual side effects even after the cessation or stopping the finasteride pills. This has led to a huge number of patients needing an alternative treatment, because back in the late 90s and 97 or so, when finasteride was first introduced, we've been prescribing that for the longest time to help patients slow down their hair loss. Now, some people didn't respond, and some people did report sexual side effects, but now it's a different story. A lot more people are very concerned about taking drugs like that. Now, minoxidil, which is the other drug, is a topical. It does not stop hair thinning. It doesn't prevent progression of hair loss. It will create the illusion of more hair by prolonging the growth cycle of thinning hairs. So I'll tell you what we do in our practice, and it's something that I think is worth learning about. We developed a treatment called hair regeneration. This treatment was a kind of an accidental discovery using a wound healing material initially used for the treatment of the scar or the incision line where a hair transplant is harvested, and to improve the survivability of hair grafts during surgery. What was discovered is that thinning hairs actually became thicker. So what we did over several years is develop a method of formulation and a process for using this as a treatment, as a standalone treatment. And now with the hundreds of patients that we've treated from all over the world, we have more than enough data to state that for men who are up to a certain level of hair loss, that the results of hair regeneration actually exceed the results of hair transplantation. Now, this is, of course, based on what the existing hairs, the state they're in. Hair that is thinning, or I would sometimes refer to hair that is dying, we can save the dying, but we can't bring back the dead. That means that if you're shiny, smooth, bald for a long time, then hair regeneration is not likely to be of that significant benefit for you. The exception being if you have lost a lot of hair and you're down to a relatively small area that is thinning and you want to save that area, well, then you'll probably do very well. So in a situation like yours, and what we're seeing a lot more because we've learned that early intervention really makes a difference, we're treating most of our patients first with hair regeneration and then observing them regularly for every 3 months for approximately 18 months. And with this, during this time, we have learned that the response rate for men is just about 100%, and it's just a matter of when and how much you respond depending on various factors. And from our perspective, the earlier someone comes in after they're noticing hair thinning, the better their results are, because there's a lot more hair to salvage. Hair grows in cycles, and eventually it continues to thin until a point where it stops growing. In those earlier stages, you can really get a lot of benefit. But we have been surprised by many patients who are far more advanced, and we never would have imagined that they had would have such a robust response, and many have done just that. So my recommendation for you is first explore your options. When you look at hair transplant, right now the major alternative to medical therapy that has been the standard for so many years has been hair transplantation. And it was an acceptable alternative since there was nothing else. What we've been able to establish is that hair regeneration is a very viable alternative. It's a single injection that appears to last in the majority of patients for 3 to 5 years, and we don't know if it lasts longer because that's the amount of data we have from the development of this procedure. It is really an exciting time, and I think that when you ask these types of questions, you get the opportunity to learn more about your options. Now, if you have a particular goal in mind, let's say you want to really define your frontal hairline, well, it is not uncommon for us to first treat a patient with hair regeneration, bring back a lot of their hair, and then do a more strategic hair transplantation to define their frontal hairline as they desire. Of course, we always have to be realistic and understanding the limits of hair transplant is so important before you move forward with surgery. But with that being said, understanding also hair regeneration and medical therapy so you can make a more informed decision when you're ready. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.